piss off.
I don't even know what mine is, but well, Minnesota MMA News, welcome. We're back. Episode 2, Diva's Dirt, a.k.a. Diva Does Kato.
Literally?
Yeah. We got Ben Pearson, Minnesota MMA News God, I guess. I don't know. He's the creator. He's the legend. I'm just one of his puppets. But I don't know, Ben, what are you excited to see tonight? This Gamebred fight night.
There's a couple fights that really jump out. The girl fight, for one, for sure. Hope and Christina.
Joe.
Yeah, that's going to be, you know, they already fought once and Christina won, but Hope's way better, but Christina's way better too. Mm-hmm. Everybody, you talk to the guys in Mankato and you talk about Christina, and a lot of times when you're rolling with a girl, it feels like you're rolling with a girl. Mm-hmm. Christina feels like you're rolling with a guy. She's so freaking strong. Like, I don't know, she's going to be nuts if she goes to the ground tonight, because there's just no reason to, because she's not getting hurt on the feet. So That's probably maybe the one that I'm most looking forward to. But then also Ben Lindau and Thomas Herrera is an interesting fight, because both of those guys are kind of legit prospects to me at 185. So
Okay. It'll
be interesting.
Going back to the girl fight with Christina Job, Hope Safner, where do you see those two stack up in the Minnesota ranks as far as females? I mean, I train with Caitlin Young. You know, she's amazing stand-up. You know, her grappling is getting better all the time, rolling with everybody, all of us at the academy. I mean, you have, there's a bunch of great Thai boxers. Katie Vogel comes to mind. Kelly Cobalt.
Is Kelly coming in there?
Shannon. Kelly's up at Spartan.
Okay.
Quite a bit. I think she's still at Ambition. You have Shannon Olson. Now Shannon Nelson. She just got married. Facebook tells me, you know.
We've heard. Rumor.
Yeah. But where do you see those two stack up in the female ranks in the state?
I think there's light years between those top three and everyone else.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, you get Kendra Ruff is right in there, too. She's taking a little break to do the football thing. And they're just... It's
LFL, Minnesota Valkyrie.
Yeah. Get on that.
Yeah.
Literally.
Oh, boy.
I'm in big trouble. I just think there's such a huge difference between those top three and everybody else. But, you know, it's a matter of time. You got to look at how long those three girls have been doing this. I mean, they've been in the, you know, since MMA started, those three girls have been doing this. So it's really tough to compare those three to the other ones. I think everybody else is right in the mix now. Christina lost to all the top one. You know, she lost to Kendra in a fight she was winning the entire round and then went to the ground and got caught in an armbar right at the end of a round that she had won. So I would love to see that fight again. I mean, that's two very strong, powerful girls that have about as much muscle as you're going to fit at 135. So, you know, I think they're all kind of right in the mix there after that next level. But to make that jump to beat a Caitlin, a Kelly, or a Shanna, it's a long way. It's going to take time.
Okay. And the other fight you were excited about?
Lindau and Herrera.
Okay.
That was, you know, there's a couple other ones that, you know, I feel like Reem shouldn't have trouble tonight. It's going to depend where his head is. You know, when he's there, kid's unbelievable. I mean, he's another guy at 85 that, you know, I'd love to see him fight one of the guys that we were talking about, Lindau and Herrera, but he's got to get there mentally right now, and he's kind of coming back into it. You know, he kind of lost it for a little bit, and now he's back to where he needs to be and focused, and I think this is probably going to be his last amateur fight.
Okay.
You know, and I think he is, when he's mentally there, he's as good as anybody at 85.
I'm kind of excited to see all the fights. I mean, I'm a driller promotions, you know, I fought for Vivid, all that sort of thing, so I don't get to see a lot of these brutal fights.
Speaking of, two weeks ago, you had a fight.
I did. I had a little bit of a little tussle at Epic.
Pretty quick.
It was like 2 minutes or something. It kind of went how I figured it would. I first minute, feel him out, kind of do my best bullfighter impression, you know, ole, that sort of thing.
he came winging.
He's trying to knock my head off, but I mean, got to keep this pretty. So, but you know, it kind of went how I figured. I mean, it was kind of funny because he got me up against the cage. I was like, oh, dude, this guy's kind of strong. It's time to go down, you know? So I tripped him, sweeped him, got on top of him, and kind of did my thing.
A pretty finish.
Did what Volkman taught me how to do.
Finish.
Pretty, yeah. Was the finish prettier than the dance, though?
Yes.
I mean, I think I'm starting to get known for my dance moves around
you
the state.
You are. I mean, between Diva's Dirt and the dancing and the sick things that Hackemuller does with your photos online. Yeah, I think you're getting pretty well known.
I mean, I'm ranked 7th in Minnesota as far as 135, but as far as dance moves, I think I've yet to be beaten. I'm
trying to think if anybody's even...
Came close?
Or tried one.
I don't think they try.
No.
Kind of a fool.
So yeah, I'd say you're definitely number one. All weight classes.
Oh. Pound for pound, best answer.
When I walk on by, girls be looking like Debbie Fly. I pick to the beat, walking down the street in my new the freak, yeah. This is how I roll, animal print pants out of control. It's Red Bull with the big ass bra, and like Bruce Lee, I got the clout, yeah.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
I work out.
Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body. Girl, look at that body.
Sean, the Muscle Shark Shirk here. Teammate, coach, friend of mine. He's in town tonight for the Gamebred Fight Night, and you're doing a little seminar tomorrow. What's going on with that?
Mankato Martial Arts, 9 a.m.
9 a.m.?
Yep.
If you're in town, I mean, well, you're not going to see this. It's going to be on Monday, so you know you're not going to be around for it, but I'm going to be at the seminar. I'm excited. I mean, he teaches a lot of great stuff. Being a former UFC lightweight lightweight champion of the world.
I look like a light heavyweight.
I'm in the off-season mode too, but I actually have your Elevation Training Master. You want to talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, this product right here is something I started using probably about 4 or 5 years ago in my training camps. I never let anyone film it or see it or even know what it was, so it was just strictly something I was using. We put a little YouTube video of me doing some sprints on it, and I was contacted by a business guy, so we came up with the Elevation Training Mask. It's doing very well. A lot of pro athletes are using it. Anderson Silva's a big advocate. John Jones, Diego Sanchez, just to name a few. But we've been approached by every top fighter in the industry. And not only that, but runners and marathoners and swimmers and military guys. And we got yoga people using it. Just everyone from every walk of life is using this thing. So it's been very well.
Everybody sees it on all the fighter shirts that come on the UFC. I'm sure they're a little curious. I mean, can you explain a little bit what all this is about right here?
Well, this is the level two. There's three levels of air resistance. Air resistance is known for having many different physical effects in the body. It's gonna create resistant air breathing, so it strengthens the lungs, makes the body create more red blood cells. It's good for claustrophobic. Those of us who have grappled before, like you and me, we've been in chokes on many occasions, right? This actually helps for that because it helps you restrict your breathing and helps you relax when your air is being cut off. So three different air resistant levels. The orange is level two. Level three is the yellow. That's the easiest. Level one is the red. So the people that are using the red, the hardest level is there's yoga instructors using it. There's singers using it. You know, singers, the lung capacity is really good lung capacity. So this thing's done, it's gone farther than I imagined. And there's a lot of people using it that I have never even imagined. You know, I mean, singers are using this thing for the lung capacity because longer notes they can sing. Obviously, the better singer they are. Right?
Now, is this going to make my interviewing skills better?
You can get more words out without having to stop and take a breath. For sure.
It'll help my stuttering.
No, it definitely helps.
Well, there you have it, you know. He's doing a seminar tomorrow. He's here for the fights tonight. Are you looking forward to watching the fights? You know, you're not fighting, so you get to, you know.
I get to relax a little bit and have some fun. I'm always interested in watching the up-and-coming talent. You know, I do events like this. I do events like this every weekend. You know, every weekend I'm in a different state, different
countries.
Different fighters, sometimes different countries. So I'm actually home this weekend, which is nice. I get to see some of the local talent.
Yeah, it's definitely nice to have him around. I mean, he beats us up all the time. Not gonna choke him. He's been doing this for years. Not gonna choke him. But cool. There you go.
Really, when I don't walk, I'm going to Chevy, shut up! Hey!
Justin Reeves is ugly.
Chevy, shut up! All right, let's do an interview.
What's up, Minnesota MMA News? We're in the Mankato State Hockey Locker Room here with Dan Barrett.
Minnesota State Mankato.
Minnesota State Mankato Hockey Locker Room tonight. All right. Dan Barrett won his fight tonight. He beat Corey Anderson in the, was it the third round?
Second round.
Second round TKO. How did you feel coming into the fight? Like, what did you mentally prepare yourself, physically? How did your camp go?
Camp went real well. Did have a couple of injuries I was dealing with, but nothing too serious. Everything went really good. I was at weight real early. Everything felt well for that. I'd fought him before, so I had confidence going in. Knew I just had to do it. I wanted to execute my game plan, and things would go my way.
What was the game plan? Did you want to stand with him? Did you want to wrestle, take it to the ground?
I wanted to stand. I knew he was a good wrestler and that he wasn't going to try to stand for too long, so I was trying to defend his takedowns. When he did go to the ground, I just tried to get down in position. I really wanted to knock out. Got a submission on him last time. He didn't really feel that it was such a great fight the last time, so when a guy wants a rematch, he kind of wanted to make him not want another one. So knockout was in my sights.
Yeah, I mean, I thought you tag him with a hard right, like swear in the face. I didn't see exactly where it hit him, but I was like, all right, he doesn't want anymore. But I was an entertaining fight to watch. Might be fight of the night. I mean, he got that takedown right away. Kind of put you on your, on the back pedal a little bit. Is he as strong as he looks? He looks like a strong dude.
Yeah, he was real strong, and he was dedicated to get the takedown. I don't think he wanted to stand there, so he hopped in on a single, and he had it tight. I defended for a while, ended up getting in there, good guard, but he looked to pick me up and slam me. That didn't really work out too well, so stood up, got a little sprawl out of there, so got back to the feet. Got a little exchange.
Yeah, it was an excellent fight to watch. One question that I'm sure everybody's wanting to know. Do you like my glasses?
They are very nice. I'm glad you just found one laying on the floor in the locker room. I hope they're sanitary, somewhat at least.
I hope also, for the future of mine, fighting.
Yeah, a bad rash doesn't break out. You don't have to wear darker ones to hide it. But they are very nice.
Well,
145 for your pro debut?
Maybe. Depends.
Can you make 45?
I can make 45. But,
you're not cutting that much, are you?
No, I don't. I mean,
who's doing the interview?
Me?
It's just background questions coming through. I usually try to get in long training camps and make it there and get down early. I've cut weight for a long time, so I feel like I'm pretty good at it. There's probably some other things I can learn. But I try to get down there pretty early and not try to have to really dehydrate myself and being there. I pride myself in my cardio and being able to push guys. So. I was down right away, especially for this, because I'm 162, so that was not big. Well, yeah, and that's 7 pounds up from what I bought at the last time. So, 55 is a little cut, 45 would be there, but if someone wants to offer me the money to cut the weight, I'd...
Is that the 14 fights, first time you've been taken out?
Yes.
First time you've ever been on your back?
No, not the first time I've ever been on my back.
But first time actually taken?
Yes, went for guillotines and stuff standing. My first title. Crazy shower action in the back around
love
there.
Love the shower action.
I think Kransky just got...
He just got iced.
Iced.
the first Evan Johnson fight, I went for guillotine. He slipped out and I was on head guard for a couple minutes until I armbarred him. But yeah, first time actually getting taken down, yes.
So, good fight then.
Yeah, obviously I got some takedown defense to work on. My percentage is 5% on the takedown.
99.4.
Yeah, my takedown defense stats.
Which way now to go? Because it's drizzling, everything goes up vertical above the clouds like flow. How I got here, I don't really know. I remember like the Alamo. Sort of gives me direction on this journey.
What's going on, Minnesota MMA News? We got Justin Ream here, victorious tonight. He was in the main event.
The Reaper.
What's his nickname?
The Reaper.
The Reaper. Justin the Reaper Ream. How did you prepare yourself for this fight? How'd your camp go?
I slacked.
I 2 weeks? Two hard weeks?
I'm not going to make excuses. Had a lot going on. My own fault. But came back in, hit it hard the last 3 weeks, and just believe in myself and what everybody tells me I can do. And, all I could do is go hard for the time I had, and I did.
Now, he looked strong. Was he strong?
I have.
Freaking ox.
He was an ox.
Couldn't get rid of his overhooks. Couldn't move my arms. Looked like a lazy bum, but I got the takedowns and got the win, so can't complain.
Standing there, do you know what you want? Are you a little concerned?
I believed I won. You know, I knew there was a chance with the judges. You never know. You know, I even believed I won the second round. I had two big takedowns. I probably controlled a minute, you know, 2 minutes of the round. You know, he caught me with a big punch. But I know either way, I had to come out aggressive the third round, and I might not have landed a lot of big punches, but controlled his hips, and I think I got a couple big takedowns that secured the win. So,
is that it for you amateur-wise, or are you
We'll talk to the guys. I believe so. I'd like to, you know, besides being here in Mankato, get to Rochester, to the cities, and, you know, get with some of the bigger guys and see what they say. You know, get the hands going. You know, the guys down here tell me my hands are good. I just never use them in the fight, so we might as well get that going before I get in trouble with the pro circuit.
I was going to say, to me, that was one of your better wins, only for, I don't think you were mentally 100% for that fight. And for you to get a win when you're not mentally 100%, doesn't happen very often.
I felt mentally good the third round. it took two
Actually,
rounds.
Actually, the end of the second round, I thought was how you should have fought that fight. You know what I mean? When you finally got on top, you finally raised up instead of, I know what you said. Yeah, you finally raised up and let him have it a little bit. And when you kept it on him, you know, what was he going to do? So, what happens now? I mean, you're going to take some time off, or you're going to...
He's going to come train with the Diva.
Would like to. Otherwise, I hear the Diva might be on a card right after New Year's, and I've been talking to Jeremy about that, and we'll see about that. So, see what the promoters have to do. Like to do it in, you know, 9 weeks, actually get a good training camp in, and go from there.
You want to talk about his entrance?
Because
that was probably one of the better.
He came out to the song Sexy and I Know It. Much props.
Hold on.
Whoa.
Uh-oh.
Pump the brakes.
Uh-oh. We got a Minnesota MMA news first here. He's leaving the conversation.
Those were already warned in an interview earlier. I don't know if you're aware of that.
I don't care. I came up to Sexy and I Know It.
He did. And he's sexy. And he knows.
Whose idea was that?
Mine and Gus's. So it's called After Hours Workout with some people at 10:30 at night. We decided to put this in. So thank the five people there.
Shout out to who gave you that idea?
Gus, Angie, somebody else, and Dan.
The crowd really got into it. I mean, that was probably the highlight of my night. I mean, that's a jam right there. Gets me going.
All right,
I was supposed to dance out behind you, but I totally lost track of time and whatnot. But, you know. But who do you want to thank for this? Like,
Gamebred Fightwear, MMA News, sorry I can't talk, The Diva, Dan Moret, Gus Kratzky, Ray White, all of Mankato, Gamebred Fightwear, and Complete Nutrition. If it wasn't for you guys, this wouldn't happen tonight, so thank you all.
Micah John.
Sure. Thanks.
Hey, he's good.
Beat up.
He did well tonight.
All right,
what about Ben?
Ben is...
I could.
Told you, Ben's pretty.
I told you,
pretty
naked choke.
185.
Ben Lindau,
dude, watch out,
fighter.
Kid at 85.
170. We've been talking about it.
All right, Minnesota MMA News. We're gonna head to the after party. This has been Diva Does Kato.
Room 411. What's up?
Room 411. That's where the party.
Shout out to my DMG rebels. Read the front of my hat. Big step, and I'll see you. What up, homie? Gonna say two letters. Diesel Dan 89. What's happening? Tell me what them letters say. Chat it up, let I'll see you, baby.
Yeah. KC!
G's up. Suckers down.